Missy was going to say that we have some beautiful flowers at the table that were arranged by my associate, Cheryl Jakinovich. I really appreciate all your help, Cheryl. Thank you very much. So just to avoid fights this evening, Missy and Tim got married on June 16th. Talk amongst yourselves afterwards. Whoever has a birthday closest to June 16th, the flowers are yours. I first entered this building in the fall of 1985. I was a young lawyer. I first entered this building in September 1985. I was a young lawyer with a full head of hair. I was a lot thinner. My glasses were a lot larger, and I had no children. I could never have envisioned that someday this venue would host a wedding reception in honor of two of my favorite people in the world, my daughter and my son-in-law. And I'm truly, truly honored that everybody is here today. You don't know what it means to all of us, to me, to Linda, to Chris and Susie, and especially to Missy and Tim. I know a lot of people traveled great distances to be here. We have people from New Mexico and Washington, D.C., California, even local people. We have friends who flew in from Seattle and came by train from Philadelphia this morning, Montreal this morning, and we have people here from South Carolina. And I know I'm forgetting, Arizona. The lady flew in last night from Arizona. So we really, really appreciate it. I'm humbled by it. And I'm going to share something with you that there's one couple that did something that nobody else has done. And you're going to be surprised when I tell you this, but one couple flew in from Charlotte, North Carolina. And my toast on your wedding day, I used some lyrics by the Broadway composer Jerry Herman. I'm going to use some other Jerry's lyrics now from Michelle Abadari. Miss you, Tim. It's so nice to see you back where you belong. At my toast in Charlotte, I said I wasn't going to mention the word grandpa. And I agree with Tim, with Chris, that would be unfair to the kids. I'm not going to put the pressure. I'm going to keep that promise, and I'm not going to mention that word today as well. But at my toast in Charlotte, I said, I truly love being a dad. I think it's the greatest job in the world, and I am blessed to have two beautiful and wonderful daughters who I love very much. Our family now includes my wonderful son-in-law, and in case somebody's living under a rock, the most gorgeous golden doodle in the state of North Carolina. Possibly in the world. Trust me, if Griff could be here today, he would. He sends his regrets. And we're thrilled, like the Hartsards, to have Tim in our family, and I think it's a great relationship, and it's going to be a wonderful marriage. And at the end of my toast in Charlotte, I said, I hope that in 50 years, we're all gathered again together to celebrate their golden wedding anniversary. And about an hour later, my wonderful daughter, the bride, came over and said, you know, Dad, you told us it was lovely, but you made a mistake. You're not going to be here in 50 years to celebrate with us. And I thought about it, and she may be right. And as a couple of months have transpired since the wedding day, I started thinking to myself, what might she have said to me if she really didn't love me? So oftentimes in a court of law, the judge will ask us to rephrase the question. So I'm going to take the liberty now of rephrasing my toast. Missy, Tim, I love you both very much, and I wish you only the best things in life, not only today, but always. Good health, happiness, peace, joy, prosperity, success, and lots of love and laughter. And I still hope that 50 years from now, you will gather with your friends and family to celebrate your golden wedding anniversary. And if perchance I am not present to celebrate your 50th wedding anniversary and my 109th birthday, then it is my hope, my desire, and my wish that my beautiful grandchildren stay up in my absence and toast their wonderful parents. Congratulations to you, my father and my grandchildren. Enjoy the party.
Hey, Barry.